हेलो एंड वेलकम टू एजुकेशन एट SSBJ ऑनलाइन वीडियो ट्यूटोरियल्स एंड हियर वी आर विथ अनदर चैप्टर सिंथेटिक फाइबर्स एंड प्लास्टिक्स ऑफ क्लास 8 CBSE. हियर वी गो. वी समटाइम्स give an example of cotton fabric, silk fabric, linen fabric, wool fabric, and what do you mean by fabric? Fabrics are those fibers used in clothing, right? So there is no much of difference. When the fiber is used in clothing, they are called fabrics. What are fibers then? And where do we get fiber? Fibers are naturally obtained. Fibers are plant-based as well as animal-based. But do you know, they can also be made artificially. They can be also synthesized. In plant-based, they are also called as roughages. Now, can you name some natural fibers? Common natural fibers sourced from the plant kingdom are cotton, flax, bamboo, jute, and many more. And here, the main component is cellulose. You must have studied cellulose in your previous class. Cellulose will be there around the cell wall of a plant cell. From animals, we get popular fibers like wool, silk. Fibers are also used for making a large variety of household articles. We use them as fabrics, that is, for clothing, as well as for home furnishing. In this chapter, we are going to learn about synthetic fibers. And what are synthetic fibers? Fibers which are made by human beings. That is why these are called synthetic or man-made fibers. Synthetic fiber is a chemical substance. It is not natural. Small units of chemicals are connected and becomes a large single unit. And that single unit is called polymer. The word polymer comes from two Greek words, poly, which means many, and mer, which means a part or a unit. So a polymer is made of many repeating units of chemicals, right? Do you know polymers occur in nature also? Cellulose is the best example for a polymer. You all know about silk. Silk is a natural fiber. And how do we obtain silk? We obtain silk from silkworm. Silk fiber obtained from silkworm was discovered in China and was kept as closely guarded secret for a long time. Fabric obtained from silk fiber was very costly, but it was so beautiful and attractive, fascinated everyone. Attempts were made to make silk artificially. Towards the end of 19th century, scientists were successfully made fiber having properties similar to that silk, and that fiber was called artificial silk. Remember, artificial silk. And that artificial silk is called as rayon. But wait a minute, rayon again is obtained from natural substance. Rayon is made out of wood pulp. Although rayon is obtained from a natural source, that is wood pulp, yet it is a man-made fiber. It is cheaper than silk, but just look like original silk. It can be given colors. It can be mixed with other fabrics such as cotton to make bedsheets, carpets, and so. The second type of synthetic fiber is nylon. You must have heard this name. Nylon is another man-made fiber. In 1931, it was made without using any natural material. Like in the previous case, rayon was made using wood pulp. But it was artificially made, man-made. This is also a man-made, but the raw material which is used here is coal, water, and air. And this is the first fully synthetic fiber. Nylon fiber is very strong, elastic, and light. And it shines. And it is very easy to wash. So it became very popular for making clothes. We use many articles made of nylon. Nylon socks are there with us, nylon ropes. Nylon ropes are very strong ropes. Nylon tents are there. Toothbrushes are made of nylon. Car seat belts, sleeping bags, curtains, and so many. Since ropes made up of nylon are very strong, they can withstand for more weight and hence used for rock climbing. Nylon thread is stronger than steel wire. Well, dear children, we'll pick up few questions out of the syllabus which is covered so far in this video lesson, right? And we'll go ahead and discuss the answers of these questions. The first question is, why some fibers, why some fibers are called synthetic, right? Why some fibers are called synthetic? Now, what do you mean by synthetic? Synthetic means man-made, made by human being. And you all know, for example, nylon is the first synthetic fiber which is made completely using the chemical substances. Right. Now, these synthetic fibers are polymers. And what do you mean by poly? Poly means many. And mers means unit. So what does it mean that small chemical units, they connect small chemical units. Suppose if this is a chemical unit, another chemical unit is connected here, another chemical unit is connected here, and here and here and so on, it becomes a larger molecule which is called polymer, right? So we can write the answer this way. Some fibers are called synthetic fiber because they are man-made fibers prepared by using chemicals, right? Chemicals. These are made of small units, I said, isn't it? Units are small, they are actually called monomers, right? So they are called mono. Mono means single. So many monomers combined together called polymer. They join together into a long chain. So some examples are nylon, acrylic, polyester, and so on. I'm sure that you have understood this. We'll go for the next question. Mark the correct answer. Now the second question is, mark the correct answer. Rayon is different from synthetic fiber because, look at this, rayon. We have studied so far rayon and then nylon, right? We'll recall all the informations of rayon now. Now, question is, rayon is different from synthetic fiber because it has a silk-like appearance, right? It has a silk-like appearance. But is it only because of silk-like appearance it's a different one? Second one, it is obtained from wood pulp. Look at this. Third one, its fiber can also be woven like those of natural fibers. What do you feel here? Many of the substances are there, they are look like a silk. Is it only because of this reason rayon is different? No, not at all. Rayon is different because it is made up of wood pulp. And why it is different? Because it's the only synthetic fiber which is made up of natural substance or natural material, right? Therefore, the answer is this. The third question we'll take up is, fill in the blanks. Fill in the blanks with appropriate words. Synthetic fibers also called dash or dash fibers. Okay, don't get confused here, right? Straight away remember these words. Synthetic fibers are called, tell me what is the answer? They are either artificial or man-made, right? You can write here as artificial and here or as man-made. Simple questions, okay? Just remember this terminology. This question is from the textbook, NCERT textbook. Second one, synthetic fibers are synthesized from a raw material called. Now, remember this. Okay, I said the nylon is made out of coal, water and air, isn't it? And nylon is a synthetic fiber. Most of the synthetic fibers are made out of coal-like materials. And what do you mean by coal-like materials? These are the substances we obtain when we process petroleum, right? Where the petroleum is available, it is underground, down. So petroleum is available underground, and when we bring it on the top, we get many substances like wax, kerosene, petrol, right? And so many gases, even coal, coal gas, all that you will study. All these are called petrochemicals. All these are called petrochemicals. Remember this, they are called petrochemicals. Therefore, you have to write here, synthetic fibers are synthesized from raw material called petrochemicals. The last one is, like synthetic fibers, plastic is also a... This is not taught. So we'll just for time being, we'll leave it. Okay, we have not covered our portion here. Okay, we'll look at the answer in the next video class. So here we will stop. Right, recall every time all the previous video contents. We'll meet again in the next video. Thank you. Be strong. Be healthy. And how you are going to be strong? Don't spend more of time in front of the laptop or a computer or a smartphone. Involve yourself more in physical activities. That is what is required. Okay? Thank you.